Dr. Fu, okay.
Okay, good morning, everyone. Thank you very much for coming. I hope all of you or some of you had a chance to see the patient upstairs. So it'll just be a kind of a quick sharing of a history of an interesting patient, and I'd love to hear what you all have to say as far as possible intervention. If it wants to work.
It might take a second.
Okay, so basically our patient is a 70-year-old gentleman who had presented initially saying that his vision had been blurry over the past year. And his past medical history is unremarkable. Just to give you a little bit of an idea of where he started. In 2007, he presented with vision of 20/20 and 20/50. And at that time, it was deemed that he had a cataract. And so he was approached with the idea of using a multifocal resume lens, which he thought would be a good option. Even though at the time, by keratometry, he was noted to have about a diopter and a half of astigmatism. Sorry, 2.5 diopters of astigmatism. He still went ahead and had a resume lens put in. The plan was to put in a 17-diopter lens, which would allow for a final refraction of minus 0.1. Well, with regards to his postoperative course, at post-op month one, his vision was in the 20/25/20/30 range, and as you can see, he started off with 3/4 of a diopter of astigmatism. As he was continued to be followed, his vision actually worsened, and he was noted to have some SPK, and he was told that his vision will continue to improve if he's compliant with his tears and uses some ointment at bedtime. And actually, doing so did make his vision 20/20, but you'll notice that he now has a diopter and a half of astigmatism. And he's noted to have some tiny filaments as well. At that point, his road of many, many drops in medicine started, and he was placed on muro, FML, and restasis. So now by post-op month 7, he presents with vision in the 20/70/20/80 range. And he's described as having this inferior epitheliopathy with about 2/3 of the cornea staining with irregular epithelium. At that point, his ophthalmologist decides to put him on acyclovir, and then is seen a month later, and unfortunately noted to have no improvement. And he's given feedback along the lines of, wear sunglasses, maybe that's why your cornea is not healing. So by post-op month 9, interestingly enough, his vision improves. However, he now has 2.5 diopters of astigmatism, and he's taken off the acyclovir, punctal plugs are placed, and he's recommended to have aggressive lubrication. So now by post-op month 11, his vision is 20/20 with 2 diopters of astigmatism. So just taking a moment here, if you had a patient like this, what would sort of be your next course? Any thoughts? Bashful group? Okay, so what they ended up doing is they offered him PRK. They offered him PRK to sort of treat this residual astigmatism and improve the quality of his vision. Well, interestingly enough, even though the notes say PRK was offered, he actually ended up having LASIK. So keep in mind, this is while he's noted to have some sort of inferior epitheliopathy, he's offered LASIK, and the treatment plan is to treat -1 + 2. And it actually ended up being a 9-micron treatment. So first day after LASIK, his vision is 20/20, which is great. Post-op month 3, he's described as having some photophobia and watering. Post-op month 5, his vision is now back to 20/80/20/70, although needing a +1 correction with not a significant improvement. He started on doxycycline as far as efforts to help improve the state of his cornea. Now he's about 2.5 years out from his original surgery, and he's finally referred to the Moran. So he comes in to see us approximately 1 month ago, and his vision is noted to be 20/100 in the left eye. Keep in mind, the right eye has a little cataract that he's not interested in touching anytime soon. And so the vision in the left eye is about 3/4 of a diopter of astigmatism noted. And on exam, really the big things is he has some dermatoscoliosis, he has the resume lens in place, and he has some mild pink macula. So these are photos from his visit approximately a month ago. And you can see his right eye looks healthy. And as far as his left eye, initially looks great, but if you zoom in, and if we can adjust the lights a bit, perhaps. Thank you. So if you can see, there's sort of this ring here. It almost looks like a little shield. And if we zoom in, you can see that there's this sort of punctate heaped epithelium. So on initial examination, my first thought was, is this epithelial downgrowth? But on closer examination, you can actually appreciate that it's sitting on the surface of the cornea. Dr. Moshfar suggested that we get an OCT, which actually wasn't particularly helpful in this case. So thoughts at this time? The patient sort of has this long history. It's not necessarily certain that this is related to the LASIK, though in retrospect, I wonder why PRK wasn't necessarily followed up with. Yes? No, there was no comment. No. It had just said that there was some SBK. That was sort of the extent of the description. Yes. I'm sorry, epithelial maladherence?
Non-adherence.
I think that's a possibility, because why clinically would it present with sort of that heaped appearance? Clearly, it's not laying down flat. Yeah, I think it would have been appropriate to maybe scrape the area or do a polishing or use a burr to sort of allow that epithelium a fresh chance to readhere. Yes. Yes. Right. That's the thing. Exactly. So he's actually been on tears up to this time, and he says that he uses the tears maybe once at night, and the lesion itself before was about 4 by 3 millimeters in area, and today it's measuring about 1.5 by 3. So it's improving spontaneously. His vision today actually pinholed to 20/25, so it's possible that with a new pair of glasses, his vision may improve. And I think this is just a slide of some of the thoughts that sort of crossed our mind. But sort of something along the lines of a persistent epithelial defect, though he didn't have a history of a defect, but certainly unhealthy epithelium. So at this point, as far as recommendations, I mean, certainly it seems reasonable to recommend aggressive lubrication. He himself says that, or rather his wife offers up that he hasn't been golfing with this weather over the last month or so. He's been home a lot. And so I think that there is a role for an environment perhaps in this case, where simply being outside and being exposed to the elements didn't necessarily help. So aggressive lubrication certainly seems like an easy option to pursue. But does anyone feel strongly that at this point we should offer him some type of scraping or necessarily just continue observation? Yes, Dr. Wilson.
So, I mean, immediately as you just look at that, even if they didn't necessarily say the sign of the field, there'd be something happening there.
Right.
As Mark said, this would be set up. I mean, the thought that you only have 20/40 vision, just a fraction. We need to write that out. I mean, all of us have seen situations like that where things finally settle down in different places. A lot of that cylinder disappears. Right. So it's a good lesson. But we need to understand that part of
take off their surface.
Sure. Your part as well.
Sure.
My sense is, the brief time I talked to him, he's in that mode, and you understand why.
Right.
That it's our problem.
Yeah.
You got to tell him at this point, and it's easier for us to, we don't necessarily need to own the original assertion.
Right.
So look, this is really a lot for you.
Yeah.
I'm also a big believer in these people. I would aggressively use omega-3 fatty acids.
Okay.
I generally find 4,000 to 5,000.
Okay.
Split at least twice a day. I throw out all the stuff, everything
yes.
you can do to try and help and enhance the quality of that epithelial
sure.
surface. And even with that, this is going to periodically run the human collection is going to take care of the fallout. I got a patient up in Ogden, and they'll call me about, every 18 months. And it's epitheliopathy post-PKP, and the vision has dropped to legally blind. 2,400. And the epithelial's off. So we'll go through all the steps, and I've actually said, I'm going to tell you the same thing all over again. Well, we think it's something else, and they'll go through it, and they'll come back to 2025.
Yeah.
And it always takes about 6 weeks. And I told him, I said, you just keep this up. And he sees well, and he thinks that's what he's going to do. Some good lessons here, but they're pretty baby there.
Would anyone recommend repeat punctal plug placement at this point as a means to sort of lubricate the surface? He's not a tear kind of guy. That's the feeling I'm getting. Yeah.
Dr. Olson said sometimes it's just like a visual aberration, but a super additive.
Right.
I think some of these little things are super additive.
Okay. Right.
I've seen a lot of patients where they say
yes. Okay. Yes. Sounds great. Well, thank you very much for your attention this morning, and thank you kindly for letting me present. Thank you.